CNN, we've had our fair share of dramatic elections recently, the UK, France, the US. And let's not forget Brexit. The German election on September 24 may be generating fewer headlines, but it's no less important. Here's why you should pay attention. Why should you care? If you're in the US, Germany is one of America's staunchest allies, but German Chancellor Angela Merkel is not a fan of US President Donald Trump. Remember the tense no handshake during her White House visit? And it seems like her main challenger, Martin Schulz, likes Trump even less, and he's not shy about ripping into the American president. So it seems, no matter who wins this election, US-German relations are likely to be strained. To borrow a phrase, Germany's the big man on campus. It has the biggest and strongest economy in the European Union. It's widely seen, along with France, as a driver of EU policy and a powerful player in the Brexit negotiations. Speaking of which, both Merkel and Schulz, a former EU president, seem inclined to take more of a hard line with the UK over its impending exit from the trade bloc. If you're anywhere else, observers of politics everywhere want to see if populist passions will reignite. They burned bright last year in the Brexit vote and the US presidential election, but have dimmed in 2017 with the loss of far-right candidates in France and the Netherlands. The parties led by Merkel or Schulz aren't populist movements by any stretch, but concerns over refugees and security could help propel the far-right AfD, Alternative for Germany, into parliament for the first time. And just like in France's presidential election earlier this year, anyone in a war-torn country in the Middle East or Africa looking to Germany as a place of refuge might wonder what kind of welcome they'll get there in the future. How does this work? Germans will be voting to fill seats in the Bundestag, the country's 598-seat parliament. Whichever party wins the most seats will try to form a coalition government, and the leader of that party will then become chancellor, equivalent to the US president. Okay, now stay with us, because from here it gets really complicated. What's the point of this convoluted system? It allows voters to split their vote between parties. They can vote for a local candidate from one party and cast their second vote for a different party. Merkel's party, the centre-right Christian Democratic Union, and its sister party the Christian Social Union, currently have 309 seats in the Bundestag. They've spent the past 4 years in coalition with the centre-left Social Democratic Party, which has 193 seats. Who could be chancellor? Who she is, Merkel, of course. Is the Merkel, of course, is the current Chancellor of Germany, an office she's held since 2005. She's the country's first female leader, and she's pretty popular right now. Her approval rating stands at about 59% in one recent poll. If the 62-year-old Merkel wins, it'll be her fourth term in the post. And if she were to serve a full term, she would tie with Helmut Kohl as Germany's longest-serving post-war chancellor, 16 years. In her time in office, there have been 3 US presidents, 4 UK prime ministers and 4 French presidents. For those who aren't fans of current US President Donald Trump, she's now thought to be the most powerful person in the world. What are the big issues? This is the big one. It's been the top concern of German voters since 2015, when over 1 million migrants and refugees arrived. Merkel's popularity took a drubbing during that time, but it's rebounded. That's a shock to many of her critics, including the far-right AfD party, which has capitalized on concern among some Germans by promising to clamp down on immigration. Issues such as family reunification, deportations and integration, as well as border controls and a possible cap on asylum seekers, both Merkel and Schulz are against that, continue to make headlines. So who's going to win? There's the fun and games of coalition building. You see, to form a government, a political party has to win more than 50% of the seats in parliament. This is highly unlikely, since there are 42 parties, 42, fielding candidates in this election. So the party that ends up with the most seats, and that, most likely, will be Merkel's Christian Democratic Union, will negotiate with others to form the government. Those negotiations start on September 25th.